necessarily translate into words. You just know it, feel it.
Call Ekman realized that our facial expressions are actually a powerful way to let others see what we are feeling.
A theater like this wouldn't work if you couldn't, at the back of the globe, be able to distinguish each of the emotions, and that's just what our research found. But the most long-distance transmitter of all is the smile. You can recognize the smile at 70, 80 meters away, just about the distance that you can throw a rock or a spear.
The young psychologist went to live with the last remaining Stone Age culture on Earth.
In 1967 and 68, I worked in the Hydrants of Guinea, which at that time had had no contact, really virtually no contact with the outside world. Most of the people I studied, I was the first or second outsider they had seen, and they had never seen a photograph, a magazine, a mirror, television, film.
Paul Ekman wanted to know whether the facial expressions used by people in the industrialized world were different from the expressions of these tribes. In other words, do facial expressions change as societies develop, or are they fixed and universal?
Actors to show their expression. You know, a child had died, show what your face would look like. If you were about to fight, show what your face. And I found exactly the same thing I found elsewhere.
Muscle for muscle, the facial expressions this ancient, isolated culture used were the same as our own. Ekman went on to suggest that these universal expressions revealed a simple set of core, universal human emotions. The basic ingredients of our entire emotional repertoire. The six basic facial expressions he identified were those of happiness, sadness, disgust, surprise, anger, and fear.